Hi! In this video, I made a tutorial about nascent page. This time is how to make a booklist page. This page consists of some sections, currently reading, about the book you are reading, here, next to read, about the book you want to read, the total book you read, and making a goal section to challenge yourself reading a book every year. And down here is a library. This is about all the books you've read or want to read. If you are looking for the properties about this book, there are many properties about this. There are the author, that start, that finish, rate, total page, last page, the progress bar, cover of the book, genre or type, status, and year of reading. So this is my booklist page on Notion to track the book I've read and to challenge myself to read more. Now I want to show you how to build this page exactly the same as mine. The first step, if you want to add page, you can add a page by clicking the plus button here. And this is the first look at the page. Now we just type the title of this page. Example is the booklist, and just click empty. Now I like add a divider for every page I create and add a quote related to this page about the book and reading, and I add some dividers again. For the booklist database, we need to add a table, but make sure it is table in line. But you can also add a database with other option views. Now we have the table here, then we just add the title for this table. Example is the booklist. Now we need to fill the table with the example information. For example, I bring the Hunger Game as an example of the book. As you can see on the video, there is an open button here to open as a page, and this is the page about the Hunger Games books. Now we just need to add some properties to this book. The information about the property is the same as I mentioned before. In this property, you can rename your property's name, and then don't forget to change your property types based on what you needed. Just because I chose The Hunger Games as an example, so I put the author as Susan Collins, and then I just add example that I start reading and that I finish reading. Then give the rating for this book, just example using star emoji. In this case, I copy paste this emoji to make it easier, and then just copy paste again until I create a 5-star rating. And after that, here I adjust the position about this star rating, but it feels free. It depends on yourself. Next is give the information about the total page of this book and the last page you read. For the progress bar, it's coming from the formula. It is like if you are using Excel with function or formula. This formula is like a system or a code to manage your information in Notion. But this time, I'm not going to explain what formula is, what it works, and what is. So now I just copy and paste the formula from my original page and then use that as an example. You can pause and screenshot the formula to use it for your Notion and click done. As you can see, this progress bar is 100%. It depends on the total page and the last page you read. If I change this last page to 200, the progress bar is 49%. And if you change the last page to 100, this progress bar is 25%. This is how the formula works. For the cover, I choose from the file I've been saved before. And just click open. Insert the genre or type of book, example about fiction and fantasy. And for the status, it is divided into three options: read, currently reading, and next to read. And here I have year of reading. This is for counting how many books I read in a year. For making some few options, I add the example for this table. This example is based on my original booklist page, and I just copy paste the information into it here. Now I want to show you how to add another option view, create a gallery view like my booklist page. You can click add a view here. Choose gallery and rename your view option. In this video, I choose gallery and click create. Now we have a gallery view here, but there is no information about the book or the cover book like my booklist page. So you can set that card preview in this button option. Choose the properties, click card preview, choose cover as preview, and then click the feed image. Now the gallery option view, it's come with the cover of this book. And down here you can click some properties to show in gallery. Example, I click author, genre or type, and status. And you can also show all, but I don't want to do that because too much information. And this is the gallery view looks like. Now I want to create the sort by or based on the author's name. So I choose author and sort by ascending. And then I want to add sort again with the title is ascending. And now this is so informative book gallery in my Notion. Next, I want to make another option view. It is about the book I've read before, and it comes with gallery view too. Then set the properties, it is same as like before, and choose the properties to show in gallery, it is same like before. Make a sort by authors and title same as like before. And here I want to add a filter based on status. It is a book I've read before, and you can choose the rating for this book, and it will appear in this gallery view. Now we have the booklist database. After we have the database, now we can add another section. Example, currently reading. Second is next to read, and the last is read. Here I make a background color as mark of the heading. it is purple color. Drag them into three columns and adjust to look prestigious. To add information for the database, you can create a linked database. Select your database booklist template and it will appear here. Next is to change this view to a list view. And it looks like this. Setting the properties to show in the list. Just because I divided this section for currently reading, I want to add a filter based on status and choose currently reading. Same steps for this. With a link database, choose booklist template and change the view with a list view. But the difference is filter this list based on status with next to read. And it will appear here. For the read section, I put the counter widget for that, like my original page. To put the widget, I use hanifild.co to add widget for Notion. And now, to make a new one, click create a widget in the counter area. After that, rename the counter title with example read counter template and read counter. Here you can choose the icons with an arrow or plus and minus. And the final is copying links for widget and paste to Notion and create embed. You can adjust the size of this widget to fit in this page. Next is for the goal section. It is so easy to make. Make a heading 3. Next is using a quote like here, like this. It is about motivation you read this book, and it call out for counting the target. And the last is the last section is the library section. Just making a heading 3 and name library at the proper background, and this is done. It's finished. It is finished as the page with different section. For the finishing touch of this page, I add the icon and the cover. For the icon, I use minimalist icons by Notion VIP, choosing related icon. Example here, I choose a book. Copy that link, bring back to Notion, click the icon and click link and paste that link and submit. Next, I add a cover, and this is the basic cover by Notion. You can add a cover from Notion Gallery or upload your own image using an image link or search on Unsplash. I prefer using Unsplash because they have high quality photos and many options for every keyword. Choose an image that you like and it becomes your cover right now. You can also change the position to look more appropriate for the cover. And I think it is good and save this position. And now we have a booklist page here. We have three sections to separate them between the status of reading. We have a book library with some option views here. By the way, I started to build this page because I want to start read again and force myself to read a book, whether it's reading novels or other books. And in this video, I want to share with you how to build this page so you can create by yourself or with yourself. But again, it's up to you. I really like my page because it looks simple and minimalist. Even there is a web or app to track your reading status too, I still prefer using Notion. So guys, thank you for watching my video. I hope you like it and get inspired on how to use Notion and more.